Good morning, and thanks for tuning in today. It wasn't long ago that all of us were affected by a global pandemic that interrupted our lives in a very dramatic way.
On a back road in Rowley, nestled among the trees on a vacant lot, stands a gravestone memorializing the lives of 11 Rowley residents whose lives were cut short by another pandemic that swept through the North Shore more than 250 years ago. Here's Molly with the story.
The Triton community spans from Salisbury, Newbury, and Rowley. In Rowley, there's a historic cemetery where victims of the smallpox epidemic are laid to rest. Smallpox was believed to originate in Asia, but the cause of it is still unknown to this day. Smallpox can be traced back from ancient cultures to Sanskrit in India, as it spread throughout Europe, even as early as 11,000 BC, as it was described in China. Smallpox began to spread to Africa. It is then believed that a Spanish ship sailing from Africa had a slave on board who was infected. When the ship docked in Cuba, that was the start of the deadly infection spread throughout America. Inside our very own Triton district, there is a historical cemetery, the Metcalf Rock Pasture Burial Ground of 1775, the Smallpox Cemetery. There are 11 Rowley residents buried here. One of the residents being Lieutenant Samuel Burbank, who was a distinguished soldier during the Revolution and was the only Rowley soldier present for the surrender of Burgoyne at Saratoga. Unfortunately, upon his arrival, Lieutenant Burbank passed away from smallpox in 1781. I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit more about the history inside our Triton community. From VTV, I'm Molly.
I never knew that cemetery was there. I love how we live in such a historical place. Thanks, Molly.
Up next, Jacob has been following our boys' basketball team for most of the season, and he shares some of the sights and sounds as well as the unique perspective of some of the players.
This is my blues, 'cause I'm back down on my own again. This is the blues I'm playing. Yes, it's a fine old thing. When the night is cold and low,
I'd say I got introduced to basketball by my family and watching like the Celtics and teams around. What I like most about basketball is just the relationships I form with my friends and, you know, just the memories that I've made over time. I don't really feel, you know, when there is challenges, I know I can just trust myself. I can trust my teammates. You know, we've all worked hard for all of our lives to get to this moment, and I feel like I can just always trust them and my coaching staff.
We have a great group of guys, and I know that I can rely on them throughout any adversity, anything we're going through. So when I do feel pressure, I know I can just rely on my teammates and my family, and they're always there for me. Thank you.
first started playing at the Ipswich Y, and I just love scoring points, getting buckets. It's just, I love that feeling when that shot goes in. Oh, I'm a big fan of the coaching staff. We got great coaches. We got Galante down, JV Taylor, of course, Coach Price and D, and of course, Travato. We got great coaches. Teammates this year are great, especially my boy, Brian Loco. Great guy, and always keeping me motivated to try my hardest. But, I mean, honestly, being a senior, it doesn't make it a big difference. But I guess the wins mean a lot more to me this year, and I feel like I'm in more critical spots, but at the end of the day, it's just basketball. I'm just trying to have fun out there.
You spend time with your family?
Sure I do.
Good. Because a man who doesn't spend time with his family can never be a good man. You look terrible. It's amazing. I'll tell you the rest of all this a month from now, this Hollywood big shot's gonna give you what you need. I'm gonna make it my offer.
One of the coolest elective classes Triton has to offer is in the Visual and Performing Arts Department.
Ceramics is an art elective students can choose after passing the Art 1 prerequisite. Here's Mrs. Fine to tell us more about this popular class.
Hi, I'm Ms. Fine, and I teach Ceramics 1 and Ceramics 2. Students who are juniors can take ceramics after taking two art classes, but it's open to any senior as sort of a senior privilege. Anyone who might be interested in working with clay or wondering what it's like to throw on the wheel or work three-dimensionally and then also be able to make mugs and bowls and cups, things that they can actually use at home. In ceramics, we primarily work with clay. We learn different techniques of hand building. We start with pinching and then working with the slab roller to create tiles and flat pieces to build architectural structures. Work with coils to make coil pots. And we also all get a chance to work on throwing on the wheel, which is what people usually think of when they think of ceramics.
I chose to sign up for ceramics because I love doing art and I knew it would be like a fun, relaxing class and it would be a nice break in my schedule.
I signed up for ceramics because I wanted to try doing art like with my hands because it's like really different and I don't get the option to like make stuff with clay and use a kiln, so.
It's a full elective, so it meets all year.
I think what I like most is the fact that like you can actually use the stuff that you make. Like I have this one mug that I make that I use all the time. So like everything you make can be practical and it's also really fun to see how it turns out after it gets fired.
I've learned to be really patient with my projects because I often rush through them and they kind of become problematic, but I've taken a lot of time recently with my projects and have been able to make them what I want them to be, and just being patient is very important.
This year we're planning a trip to the Museum of Fine Arts to see a special exhibition. When given the chance, we definitely like to get out and see ceramics in the wild.
I would say do it 100%, especially because like you can't really do ceramics like at your house, you need like a kiln. So I think it's a really good opportunity to do it like in school. And Ms. Fine has a lot of like glazes and everything, so it's like, you know, it's a good class to take. There's lots of resources and stuff, so I'd say do it.
There's usually something about it that is new and a first-time experience for everyone at some point. So although it can be helpful to have some art-making experience, it's not necessary because for everyone, it's going to be a new experience in working with clay and making something and building with clay. So I would welcome anyone who's interested in seeing what it's all about to sign up, give it a try.
In the early 2000s, before all of us were born, MTV launched a popular reality show called MTV Cribs. In each season, a group of celebrities gave producers an extensive tour of their impressive homes.
We thought this would be a fun way to meet some of our own Triton students. So without further ado, Bella brings us the first episode of VTV Cribs and takes us to Angela's house for a tour. Take it away, Angela.
Hey guys, welcome to my crib. I'm Angela and I'm going to show you around. Come on. When you first come in, there will be a dog named Cash to greet you. He's very friendly, even though he kind of looks like he could kill you. Okay, right now we're in the great room where I guess we host a lot of our family gatherings here, and it's just where people tend to sit. This is our kitchen. Nothing special. It's kind of old, but it's okay. Here is the living room. We just redid it. Still kind of old. We're starting to get to the older part of the house where it was like made, like it was like the first thing made, and then that's the extension, and then upstairs also the extension. So let's go upstairs. First door, mine. This is where I didn't really grow up in here, I guess. I moved here when I was 6, so nothing special. So here's the basement. It's connected to the great room. Yeah, I mean, this is where like all me and my friends hang out. Foosball down here, actually. One against one of me and Bella's friends. That's my mom. Look how cute she is. That's just like our shed where we keep the pool stuff in for right now. The hot tub. And then pool, if you couldn't tell. And then the first things we started building out here, I think, was the hot tub like deck thing. And then we built these things, which is like the cabana. It looks really bad right now. So I know it doesn't look like a bar, but it will be a bar, trust. Bathroom, one of the bathrooms of the pool house. And then we have our steam room. Give me a second, it takes a very long time to open. It smells like water in here. And then, yeah, and I have to shower. Nothing up here because we just finished it, so it's not furnished, nor is it painted. But when it will be, I don't know. Oh, yeah, we have a outdoor shower. Here's the barn. That's basically what it is. That fence is broken, actually. So here's the hayloft. There's nothing. It's kind of disgusting up here because, well, it's a hayloft. And we seem to be running out of hay. This one's is Marvin's. He's kind of high maintenance. He recently just had an eye surgery, so that's why he has this mask on. This is our horse, Jenga. But yeah, that's her butt. This is Gus. He's an old boy. His name's Billy. And he's just kind of, it's just kind of weird. So here's the tack room. I am not gonna turn on the lights. It's an indoor arena and it's covered in tar. This is like ripped up tire pieces and all so that. So we're right now just driving to part of the back 40 because I do not believe that I can take this all the way back. The trees have now died, actually, that the zipline is holding on to. So I haven't gone up here in about, well, you guys saw my ziplining segment. This is literally it. It's so dirty up here. Take this zipline down to the base. So here's the power lines, or
the back 40, as some people say. It's the completion of my house. Bye. Thank you for coming.
I love the kitchen in your house. I can make some banger meals in there.
Speaking of delicious food, mac and cheese is number one on my list for a can't-miss meal any time of the day.
You know who makes a mean mac and cheese?
Who?
Mia Dupuy. And in this next segment, Mia shares her secret recipe.
Hey Vikes, what better time to learn how to make a delicious mac and cheese dish that is sure to keep you warm and cozy? You and your family are definitely gonna love it.
For this recipe, you'll need elbow pasta, cheddar cheese, all-purpose flour, whole milk, unsalted butter, salt, pepper, onion powder, and Ritz crackers. First, preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Turn on high heat and boil the water for the pasta. Cook the pasta, strain, and put it off to the side. In a large pan over medium heat, melt the unsalted butter. Pour in flour, onion powder, salt, and pepper. Gradually add in the whole milk. Whisk together. Once boiled, take the pan off the stove and add in the cheddar cheese. Mix until melted. Add in the cooked pasta and stir. Pour the mixture into a large bowl. Melt the unsalted butter. In a Ziploc bag, crush the Ritz crackers. Combine. Sprinkle the Ritz and butter over the pasta. Bake for 30 minutes. Let cool for 10 and serve.
Oh, good job, Mia. That's good.
This mac and cheese dish is so easy to make and so delicious. I would definitely recommend trying it out for yourself. From VTV, I'm Mia Dupuy. Thanks for watching.
That looks yummy. When is lunch? I'm starving.
I could literally hear your stomach growling while you watch that. Here's our question for you. What would you give up for a steaming bowl of mac and cheese right now?
Are you kidding? I'd give up my right arm for that.
Interesting. Adeline caught some of you in the hall recently and asked a couple of questions to learn about your personal priorities. Here's what you said.
I'm Adeline Stapleton, and Riley McIsaac is behind the camera, and today we are seeing how our teenagers have evolved and what their priorities are. So we asked a few controversial questions that could really show what they value in their life, but are also kind of silly.
Would you rather lose a body part of your choosing or delete all of your social media?
Delete all my social media.
Yeah, I'd rather lose a body part, and I'll take out my tailbone because it's vestigial, meaning that over time and evolution, we don't need it. And actually, I'm going to break the fourth wall here and look at the camera. Actually, we're better without it.
I probably don't need my baby toe.
Okay, thank you.
Lose a body part of my choice.
What would it be?
Probably my nose.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I'd lose a pink toe.
Oh, lose like one of my toes.
Delete all my social media.
Really?
Yeah.
100%. Even like texting? Like yeah. You lose everything.
Yeah.
Brother, you could lose like your pinky toe or something. That doesn't matter.
That would be so stupid, because then you're just missing your pinky toe. But you're like, oh, I can. Like, I'd rather just be like, oh, what's good?
You'd hate your life.
I already do.
A body part. My right hand.
Your right hand? You could do like a finger or a toe, and you're picking your whole hand.
My social media. Not gonna lie.
Thank you.
What kind of body part?
You can choose.
Yeah, I'll lose my appendix.
Okay.
Can't you like get that removed?
I think so. Smart.
Oh, delete social media.
You'd be surprised. Everyone's saying a body part.
Oh, no. Get rid of the social media. Are you kidding? I'd love for us to go back to 20th century.
What was the question?
Would you rather be a single parent or get married and never have kids?
Be a single parent?
I would rather be a single parent because I love my children dearly.
Single parent?
Why?
because I can raise my own kid.
Since I am a single parent, I'd rather be a single parent because kids are amazing.
Yes, perfect.
Get married and never have kids.
Be a single parent.
Single parent.
Single parent.
Single parent.
Our votes were not as unanimous as I personally assumed they would be. I would think a lot of more of our teens would prioritize technology and marriage and love, but it seemed to be pretty evenly split. So thank you for watching. For VTV, I'm Adeline, and again, Ryan McIsaac behind the camera.
I'm not sure I could give up my social media. How would I watch VTV's Instagram and YouTube channel?
That's true. Well, luckily, you don't have to lose a body part to stay connected with us. Just smash the like button and get a notification every time we post new content on our channel.
Thank you for watching our show. I'm Angela.
And I'm Mia.
You're taking up the whole spot.
I'm very sorry.
All right.
Air out the pits. What? Okay. You're not going to be electrocuted.
Yeah, don't touch the wires.
I never knew that the
after passing the art one
it was at this moment that he knew.
Prerequisite.
In the early 2000s, before all of us were born, MTV launched a... Oh, this is mine!
So without further ado, we thought this would be a fun way to meet some... wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Okay, I'll just be like... What was the word that we were saying? Promiscuous, no.
Prerequisite.
That looks yummy. I don't have a screen and I'm living it up over here.
Yeah, what?
So she lost quite a lot of body parts.
Hasta la vista.